Hey guys, Akasha here. Welcome back to my channel. I just got done shaving. I just forgot a little bit there. I am getting ready to do a full face of makeup with the new stuff I got from Sephora. So, if you guys want to continue watching, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so we can get this party started. Alright. Okay. So, first thing first, gotta get this face primed. Yes, gotta get this face primed, honey. They recommended this for me having oily skin, naturally oily skin. Ooh. Now that looks pretty. Yes. That looks very pretty. I'll keep the box so I can put it back in. Let's see. It doesn't have an overpowering smell, which is good. Give it all in here. Ooh, it is sticky. Hopefully the new foundation sticks to it nicely. Sorry, couldn't help that. Okay. Next, the new Kat Von D foundation in the medium neutral. I love this packaging like hell. Hell. Okay. Oh, it comes so I can put this back on. Oh. That piece comes off and I can put it back on. I didn't know that. Damn. But I better grab my handy dandy beauty blender. Actually, let's throw this one away. Yeah. Throw that one away. And grab one of these babies. New stuff, might as well use a new beauty blender. Okay, which one? Let's go with the ready one. I feel a little red today, a little wetter. It's nice and thick. And let's get this foundation on. can't forget those ears. Okay. They say full coverage. I don't think so, unless I just didn't use enough. Yeah, I probably didn't use enough. Yeah. Maybe a little more wouldn't hurt, right? Now that looks like more full coverage. I just had to add a little more because I guess I didn't have enough the first time round, which is okay. Having new foundation is a learning curve. So, all right, let me put the cap on this bad bitch on. I still like that. You know, take this off when being used and put it back on when not being used. I love it. You better work, Miss Kat Von D. Yeah, you better work. Better work, Miss Thing. And now, my handy dandy Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. To conceal these edges and hookers. Yes. Conceal and not be revealed. Blend it out. Looking good there. All right, so I'm done with this, at least for now. Let's get some bronzer and blush on this mug. chisel this face. Chisel the mug. Okay. Mm-hmm. And the blush. Apples of the cheeks. Okay, now for some setting powder and face powder. Might as well use my little flower from Beauty Bakeries. Having a little difficulty. There we go. Now this will be better. Get the baking process started by adding some flour. Good. So done with the flour. Now on to my regular powder puff. Okay, now for my handy dandy brush. Might as well use a bigger brush this time. Okay. brush away the bake. The brush away the harshness. Yes, I think it looks good so far. Yes, and now, let's put on some highlighter, shall we? Yes, let's put on some highlighter. And I'm using an old brush, but a good brush. An old brush. I knew this brush would work good. Sometimes with these highlighters, you have to build a little bit for the real blinding effect. You know what I'm saying? Next is the eyes. Let's get this girl moving. Oh. Oh. Like a box within a box within a box. Ooh, nice. I gotta show you guys this. Oh, hello. Nice big mirror, all these colors. Granted, I mainly got it because of the blues. Yes, because of the blues is the reason I got this one. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 that I can use easily for this look. Or should I try a rainbow effect? No, I'll do that little guy. Little Sobble. Yes. Do my original plan. Which was Sobble. My original plan was Sobble. It works very well like that. Okay. get my Morphe Drifter eye brushes out. Which I will be going with the yellow for a base color. There's some fallout. I'm not too mad about it. All eyeshadows have some fallout. So I don't mind it. Base color is down, which was the yellow. Time to move on. Some of this blue B5. Granted, with the yellow, it turns to green. I'm not mad at that. It's just basic color combination. Make sure some of that yellow gets through. If I need to add more yellow, I will. Now for this darker blue, B4. Doesn't look half bad. Okay, not bad at all. I don't hate it. I don't hate it at all. I actually like it. First time using a Norvina palette. So let's see. probably use some of this glittery yellow for under the eye. That is looking good. Yeah, I like that. I like that a lot. For inner corner. Let's see how this looks. Ooh, now that is pretty. Now that is pretty. This was D1. I decided to bring the inner corner down a little bit, which looks gorgeous. Bring this side down a little bit. Yes. Do I give you a water effect, guys? Let me know. And next is the mascara, because this eye look is almost done. Just put it back the way it belongs so it can stay looking good. Before I do roller lash, I need to do liner. Give this a little wing. Ooh, hey pigment. Yes.
Now, time for roller lash. I love this roller lash. I love it. Looking gorgeous. And next is, you guessed it, lips. Let this get this girl rolling. Because the lips are queen. This gets put away correctly. I think I'll go with the darker nude today, a Leo, because I feel like a Leo. I love Jeffrey's liquid lip formulas. And add a little sparkle. And last but not least, gotta set this bitch. Yes, set her. What I also like to call the setter and forgetter. But for me, you can never forget me. But hope you guys like the outcome. Did I do good? Inspiring? I hope so. Love you guys. Have a good day. And Akasha out.